They will bite you. And the thing is, some of us are coming to church. We're worshiping God. We're coming to the altar. We're praying, Lord, help me. Then after this, we go home now and we go to the nyanga and to the other guy and to the fortune tellers. Tell us, what shall he be? We just read in our scripture, our responsive reading, what the end's going to be like. Amen. Let's go back. Let's get back to chapter 19 of Hezekiah. He goes and he goes to the house of God. And he sent Eliakim. What's he got there? He sent Eliakim, which was over the household, and the Shebna, the scribe, and the elders of the priests, covered with sackcloth, and to Isaiah, the prophet of the son of Amos. And they said unto him, thus saith Hezekiah, this day is the day of trouble. Brothers and sisters, when you find yourself in the day of trouble, don't go there, go come to the house of God. It doesn't matter what day it is. The church doors are always open. You don't have to have the elders here, the pastor here, and everybody else. Just come to the house and pray. And if you can't come, you must have a prayer place in your home.
Amen.
Your closet that you go to. And you seek God and you're asking, Lord, help me with the situation that I'm finding myself in. It looks like everybody's coming against me. Everybody's coming to attack me. Lord, help me. When Peter was arrogant, by the way, Peter's the only one, I'll say it again, that ever walked on water. Guys have tried, even in Zimbabwe, they tried, they drowned. Yeah. Peter, when he saw Jesus walking on water, he was just there. Lord, if that's you, can I come? Not even to say, but this is water. You know, maybe he's standing on something, maybe it's something that he's standing on that we can't see. He just says, blindly, Lord, can I come? Jesus says, come. So Paul's Sister White says, Peter starts walking on water.
Amen.
And he's walking to Jesus. Hey, can you imagine? Hey. Then Sister White says, he turned and he looks at the others in the boat and he says, check me out. So what happened? As soon as you take your eyes off Jesus Christ, disaster comes. And 1, 2, 3, boom. No, and he didn't give a long prayer. He just said, Lord, save me. And Jesus just said, oh, Peter, come, my brother. Come with me. He never condemned him, he never ran him down, he never told him off, he just brought him up. And that's what Jesus does in our lives. The problem is, the devil tells us that we are so messed up that even God can't hear us.
Amen.
But then the Bible tells me, Jesus says in John, he's chapter 15, verse 5, without me, you can do nothing. So without Jesus, we are failures. But through him, we can do all things. Philippians says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. My God shall supply all my needs. And this is what Hezekiah simply knew. And that's all Hezekiah had to know. That's all. As we're moving on. So Hezekiah is there. He calls to the priest, the high priest. He calls all the prayer warriors. He gets the prayer team in. And he starts saying, please speak to God and ask God what is going on here. And so verse 4 says, and it may be that the Lord thy God will hear the words of Rabshakeh, whom the king of Assyria, his master, had sent to reproaching the living God, and will reprove the words of the Lord thy God hath heard. Wherefore, lift up in prayer for the remnant that are left. He's coming up and he's saying, please, Lord, look at us. We are your remnant. We may be there. We may have issues. We may have problems. But we are still your children. Turn to your neighbor right now and say to them, I am God's favorite child.
I am God's favorite child.
Now say to them again, you better believe it. Say it with conviction.
Yeah.
Yeah. And this is what Hezekiah knew. And he knew when you start insulting God, God takes over. If you look in the encyclopedia, if you look at history books, you'll find that Napoleon came and tried to fight God. And one Adventist came at the time, before the Adventists were there, and he said, You know what, Napoleon, even though it seems that you are moving, even though it seems like you are conquering and you're conquering and you're winning, but the Bible says here in Daniel that you will not win. You will not clean. Yes, and Napoleon said, aha. Same like what's happening at Charlemagne. Same story. They said when Napoleon met his Waterloo, when he came to water, battle Waterloo and Lord Nelson, when he met his Lord, when they found him, that little short guy was on his boat and he was dying. His boat on the back, doesn't matter. He was there and saying, in French, even God was just too much for me. You can't fight God. No matter how great your worldly armies are, you cannot fight God. No matter how your Assyrian armies are and your king of Assyria, you cannot fight God.
Amen.
Amen. So the servants of Hezekiah came to Isaiah in verse 5, verse 6 says, and Isaiah said unto them, thus saith, thus shall he say unto your master, thus saith the Lord. Listen to this, verse 6. Be not afraid of the words which thou hast heard, with which the servants of the king of Assyria have blasphemed me. You see, he took over. God took over. He says, don't be afraid of words. Watch this. Watch me. This guy, that's shaking. He's going to know me now. God is excited. You know, God likes to show up sometimes. He says, hey, watch. So God is sitting in heaven there, and he's enjoying heaven. And then this guy comes blaspheming and God says, Hezekiah, watch. Behold, I will send, verse 7 says, behold, I will send a blast upon him. And he shall hear a rumor and shall return to his own land. And I will cause him to fall by the sword of his own land. Hey, hey. Ah! What is Hezekiah doing? He was praying. He didn't get the army together. He just went to the house of God. This guy, verse 8 says, so Ramesheket returned and found the king of Assyria warring against Libna, for he had heard that he had departed from the Lachish. And when he heard of the king of Ethiopia, behold, he came out to fight against him, and his messengers, and against and again against Hezekiah, saying, thus shall he speak to Hezekiah, king of Judah, saying, let not thy God in whom thou trustest deceive thee. Jerusalem shall not be delivered into the hand of the king of Assyria. Behold, thou hast heard what the kings of Assyria have done to all the other lands by destroying them utterly. And shalt thou be delivered?